earlier we have gone through this design of counter for retaining walls. Up to these dimensions, then stability analysis. We have finished this stability analysis. So, then we calculated the soil pressure at the base of the retaining wall, and this will be, if I take A, B, C and D, and this term to be, if I make it into I, E, F, and this is my G, this value will be rho E is equal to 121394, and this value comes out to be 60697 Newton per meter square. And these dimensions we have calculated earlier, these dimensions, this is your 5.5 meter, and this dimension is your 1.2 meter, and this is 1 meter, and this is your 3.29 meter, and this completely 6.3 meter, and this gives your value of 6.7 meter. Now, also we have checked the stability analysis criteria, all the 4 criteria it has satisfied. Now, we will go for a design of, so first part with your dimensions, tentative dimensions or maybe dimensions. Once dimensions have been established, then we have done this stability analysis. Geotechnical point of view, stability analysis is your overturning moment, factor of safety against overturning moment, factor of safety against sliding, and E should be less than equal to B by 6, and also bearing capacity failure check. Then after stability analysis, once it is ok, then whatever dimensions we have taken consideration for this design of counter for retaining wall, these dimensions are ok. Now, after these 2 steps over, then we got the pressure below this retaining wall. Now, third part is your RCC design or maybe structural design. Structural design, in case of structural design, so particular design of, we can start with this upright slab. This is your upright slab, this is your upright slab, this part is your heel slab, and this is your toe slab, and this is your counterforce. So, for upright slabs, bending moment we have earlier calculated, it is equal to P L square by 12. This comes out to be 25200 Newton meter, and overall thickness, if you look at this thickness, this upright slab of thickness of 210 mm. So, overall thickness is equal to T is equal to 210 mm. Now effective depth can find it out, 210 minus your 40 mm for your concrete, that comes out to be 170 mm. Now area of this steel required is equal to moment of resistance, that is your 25200 divided by 140 stress in steel into 0.87, this is the value of Q into 170 effective depth, this comes out to be 1220 mm square. That means for design of upright slab, this is your steel reinforcement, this amount of area of the steel reinforcement is required. So, you can take whatever the available in the market. If I take 16 mm 5 bars, this is available in the market, then the spacing comes out to be spacing which is equal to pi by 4 into d square, pi by 4 into d square, this is your 201 into 1000 by 1220, this comes out to be 164.7 mm, and you can take it as a at the rate of 160 mm center to center. Now, this is your main reinforcement. As I said earlier, for cantilever retaining wall, you can go for also after main reinforcement, you can go for a shear reinforcement, that distribution is your 0.15%. So, shear reinforcement that is your 0.15%, 0.15 by 100 into 210 into 1000, it is coming about to be 315 mm square. If I take 8 mm 5 bar, the spacing comes out to be, spacing is equal to your 150 mm center to center. Now, this structural design, this is similar, same as you have done earlier, particularly in case of cantilever retaining walls. This will be same for upright slab as well as toe slab and heel slab. First, you will have to find it out maximum bending moment, how much your bending moment is coming. Then depending upon your bending moment, once you get it, you can make it to into QBD square, you can find it out your total depth D or total thickness T, then you can find it out effective depth. If you have your in this case upright slab, this thickness of this upright slab from this dimensions, it is given 210. So, effective depth, if 40 mm is your clear cover for concrete, clear cover for concrete, how I have done it, as I said earlier, if this is the cross sectional view, so these are the reinforcement, this cover generally your 40 mm, clear cover beyond your reinforcement, that is your 40 mm. So, this effective depth is comes out to be 210 minus 40, this is your 170 mm. Then if I equate with your moment to this moment is equal to your stress in steel, I can find it out what is your maximum area of steel, means how much reinforcement is required. So, reinforcement required is 1220 mm square, then you can take it as per the availability locally. Locally generally available 12, 16, 18, 20, 25 mm bars, you can choose any of the bar. In this case 16 mm 5 bars has been chosen and spacing comes out to be 160 mm center to center. Then as per the IS code, for structural design, for particularly working stress method, this shear reinforcement has to be provided your about 0.15%, and from there the reinforcement comes about to be 315 mm square. So, now we provide 8 mm 5 bars of spacing 150 mm center to center. The moment you go there, so bending moment will be more and here it will be less, so curtailment of bar will be there. As I said earlier, alternative bar to be curtailed. So, that means out of 150 mm alternative bar should be curtailed, means the spacing become 300 mm center to center. Now, design of the toe slab, if you look at this part, I am considering only this part from here to here, this part is your toe slab. Now, I will have to consider the pressure at the base and pressure above the toe slab and what is your net pressure. So, in this case net pressure coming about to be more in the base than your top. So, we can find it out this toe slab. So, toe slab, if I write it into this upward pressure, so like C D I F, then if you look at this C D I F, this is rectangle, then I F E, there are two component, because this component trapezoidal component you can find it out directly upward pressure, or you can make it into two component, one component this and other component is your triangular component. So, C D I F, I got these calculations, one for this 107906 into 1, this distance is 1 meter and here it is, your 107906. By simple distribution, triangular distribution, I can find it out this pressure here. So, this value comes out to be 107906. Now, upward pressure of EIF, this comes out to be half into 1 into 13488. So, if this to this pressure is 12394 and this to this is your 107906. So, this part will be 12394 minus 107906. So, this comes out to be like 6744. So, this is your total upward pressure. Then you can deduct, the self weight. Self weight is coming downward, self weight of this is coming downward with the deduct self weight. Which is equal to 1 into 0.4 into 25,000, this comes out to be 10,000, and distance from C, if I am taking from distance from C, it is coming about to be 0.5, 2/3, and this is your 0.5, and moment at C, this comes about to be 53953, then 4496, then this is your 5000, this comes out to be 53449. Now, this is your maximum bending moment after deducting self weight and taking into consideration of upward pressure. So, that means this maximum bending moment is coming to be, it will bend like this. So, with this help you can find it out, this depth is given, 400 mm, this part is given is your 400 mm from your dimensions calculations. Then you can find it out effective depth. Effective depth comes out to be 400 minus 60, which is equal to 360 mm. Now, you can find it out area of steel, it comes out to be 1290 mm square. Now, you can take either 16, because you are taking the 16 mm 5 bars, you can take 16 mm 5 bars. So, it is 16 mm 5 bars. Then you can find it out spacing about 150 mm center to center, Similarly, shear reinforcement, shear reinforcement you can take it about 8 mm 5 bars, and shear reinforcement you can find it out 8 mm 5 bars, 8 mm 5 bars at the rate of, it comes out to be 160 mm center to center. So, the way I have done this, design of toe slab, same way you can do it. This part, this design of the heel slab I am not doing, that you have to do it the way I have done for the toe slab. Particularly this heel slab, you consider the part of the stresses, you consider the part of the load coming, what are the part of the load supposed to come particularly heel slab. One is your self weight, it is coming downward, then weight of earth, that means weight of soil, it is coming downward, then weight of counterfort, because this is RCC, it is coming downward, then any superimposed load, that also you consider, then afterwards, then you take from here to here, this part to this part, the pressure distribution you deduct and see whether the upward pressure distribution is more or downward pressure distribution is more. In this case downward, whatever the self weight coming to the pressure, because this is a retained part of the soil mass, so the pressure will be more. So, this case how it will be bent, this will be bent in this way. So, if you will do it like this, the way I have done for toe slab, you can do it for heel slab and do this calculation, find it out your maximum moment. You can find it out a distance from this point B and take moment about point B, then your maximum moment after deducting this self weight, deducting this base pressure, then you find it out what is your area of steel required and main reinforcement as well as shear reinforcement. If you look at this heel slab, your maximum bending moment comes out to be maximum bending moment comes out to be 375.77.25 newton meter, and this maximum bending moment, from there you can find it out your area of steel, it comes about to be 900 mm square. Then you can take 12 mm 5 bars, so at the rate of spacing 100 to 20 mm center to center, then also you can provide minimum shear reinforcement also. So, toe slab and heel slab as well as upright slab, all this slab design has been over. Only remaining part is that this counterfort structural design has to be carried out this. Now, we will start this counterfort walls, RCC design of your counterfort walls or counterforts. If you look at this counterforts, this top width, if I can take it, whatever the width here, this width comes out from these dimensions. Generally, this width would take same width of this, like 210 mm in this case. So, this comes out to be 420 mm. That means, double the stem thickness, it comes out to be 420 mm of width of counterfort walls. Then once you get the width of the counterfort walls, then you can find it out, then next step is your find it out earth pressure distribution or pressure distribution, earth pressure. If soil is retaining like this, one pressure is giving soil pressure on the upright slab, other way earth pressure is also giving to your counterfort walls. So, this comes out to be K a gamma h square L by 2, which is equal to 1 third, k is equal to 1 third, gamma is equal to 16,000 into 6.3. This distance from here to here is your 6.3 into 6.3 whole square by 2 into L is equal to 3. L is your spacing between this counter fold, this is about to 3. So, this comes about to be 666792 Newton meter. So, overall width of the counter fold at the base, we can provide 3.5 meter. Why it is 3.5 meter? 3 at the center to center base, 3 and 3.08. If you look at this, if I draw this diagram, how this 3.5 comes into picture. This is your 0.42 meter, this is your 0.42 meter, then from there you provide this, then if I take it to the 6.3 meter, this comes out to be 3.08 meter. So, now overall width, if I add it 3.08 plus 0.42, this comes out to be your 3.5. Overall width is equal to 3.5 meter. Now, effective depth minus 60 mm, this is for 60 your concrete, this comes out to be 3440 mm. Let us put it, beta is your inclination of the main steel with your vertical, either you take it or you can take it. So, tan beta comes out to be, now tan beta 3.08 divided by 6.3. So, beta is equal to 26 degree 3 minute. Now, area of steel required, once you have earth pressure with this, from this earth pressure, this is your bending moment comes out to be. So, K A gamma H square by 2. So, then from there maximum bending moment we got it from earth pressure, this is your Newton meter. So, maximum bending moment comes out to be earth pressure 666792 into 6.3 by 2, this comes out to be 317520 Newton. So, this will be your this comes out to be 666792 Newton meter. Now, you have your effective depth, you have your maximum bending moment, then from this you can find it out your area of steel. What is your area of steel? So, area of steel comes out to be AST is equal to maximum bending moment 792 divided by stress in steel 140 into Q is equal to 0.87 into effective depth, which is equal to 3440 into say 26 degree 3 minute. This comes out to be your 1800 mm square. Now we can provide 8 numbers of 18 mm phi bars. Look at this for counterfold retaining wall. Counterfold retaining wall, what we have done? We need a thickness. We need a thickness. This thickness 210 mm is your thickness of your stem. Generally, the counterfold retaining wall which has been constructed along with this. So, whatever the thickness generally we got it, we make it double. So, available thickness means double the stem thickness. This is your thickness, that is your coming 420 mm. Then if soil is retaining like this, soil is retaining like this, it will give earth pressure on this laterally one direction on your stem as well as laterally to your counter for retaining wall. From there earth pressure comes out to be k a gamma h square by 2 into l. L is equal to spacing between your earth pressure. So, 1/3 into 16000 into 6.3 whole square by 2 into 3. This comes out to be 317520 newton. Now, overall width I have calculated. If I am taking this 0.42 meter, now this overall width is coming 3.08 plus 0.42, this comes out to be 3.5 meter. So, effective depth comes out 34440 mm. Then we calculate tan beta, this is your 26 degree 3 minute. Maximum bending moment will comes out from your earth pressure diagram, from this earth pressure. So, this is your maximum bending moment. Once you get maximum bending moment, you can find it out your area of steel. Then area of steel comes out to be 1800 mm square. So, you take what is the available, locally available, you can take it 16 mm phi bar, 12 mm phi bar or 18 mm phi bar. This comes out to be 8 number of bars. So, this is your, once you get the reinforcement, then you can think about your shear reinforcement and as well as also your curtailment of bars. Now, as I said earlier, in this case, we need to have this curtailment of bars, because at the base bending moment will be more, at the top bending moment will be less. So, curtailment of bars will be curtailment of bars, let h 1 be the depth at which, let h 1 is your depth at which say total 8 number of bars, 2 bars, let us say 2 bars to be curtailed. I put it in even number 2, 4, 6. So, 2 bar to be curtailed, then I can find it out 8 minus 2, 8 is your bar minus 2 by 8, this is your bar, then h 1 whole square minus 6 divided by 6 minus 3 whole square. So, this comes out to be h 1 is equal to comes to be 5.5 meter. That means, below 5.5 meter we can curtail the bar of every 2 bars. If there are 8 bars, that means 2, then next 2 bar to be curtailed, then 6, then next 2 bar to be curtailed. So, similarly you can go for h 2, let us say h 2 is equal to another 2 more bar curtailed. So, you can find it out 8 minus 4 by 8, this comes out to be h 2 whole square by 6 minus 3 whole square, this comes out to be h 2 is equal to 4.4 meter from top. This is your from top. So, in this way you decide from the top at what distance 2 bar to be curtailed, then another distance an additional 2 more bar to be curtailed. In this way you proceed this curtailment of bars. Now, then you will have to find it out this connection between this counterfold and upright slabs. Because once this counterfold retaining wall you get your main reinforcement, this main reinforcement has to be connected with your counter for retaining wall, has to be connected with this upright slab as well as heel slab. How this connection has to be done, this has to be also again calculated. I will do it next class along with this all detail reinforcement drawings. Thanks a lot.